One of New Zealand's biggest cities is in ruins right now. A powerful earthquake toppling buildings in Christchurch. It is the second major quake to hit Christchurch in just 5 months. This time we understand members of a U.S. delegation were there. All of them are reportedly fine. We've also learned that 9 U.S. congressmen had just left Christchurch right before the quake hit.
February 22nd, 2011, about 180 left us and ascended to heaven. Grand churches now before the Lord, splaying out their feet. Buildings that had stood for years, now lay down to sleep. Steadfast soldiers stayed in line, others swayed in time. Brick and mortar lost the game to the player made of pine. The bells on the top of the steeple fell on top of the people, as did many a rock expelled from the top of a steeple. A toy box of slotted blocks stacked up to make office blocks. Is knocked and topples off its plot, drops to a squat and stops. Shops, cars and buses destroyed, busted, crushed like toys. Just confusion in the dust and noise. Sirens faded on a brutal and scary view. We can now agree that Newton's theory is true. What goes up must come down. The universal pain of just one town. Christchurch.
As the aftershocks continue. Cameron?
Sarah, thank you. And joining me now, FEMA's Deputy Administrator Tim Manning on the phone from Christchurch, New Zealand.
I've got a floor plan here that shows incidences, and it appears to be more than just coincidence. The evidence appears to be covert influence, a sequence of events that are more than just coincidence. So many incidents, somewhere there's blueprints that show this instance was more than just coincidence. The evidence appears to be covert influence, a sequence that are clearly more than just coincidences.
I want to go to retired Coast Guard Admiral Thad Allen, who was in Christchurch, New Zealand, where this quake hit. Admiral, I'm very pleased to find out that you're okay too, but what were you
now
doing there?
To explain what I'm about to, we have to go back near a century. Tesla sent electricity through the air independently, consequentially without consent. The U.S. seized his invention, sealed in the center of sensitive secrets, secured for selfish intentions. Yes, it was stolen for the American dream of war and a global weather controlling scheme. The regime can beam offshore, but this ELF projector needs conductors to comply. So planes spray metal oxides and construct them in the sky. Was this technology used to enhance the blind trust on a full moon high tide and blame it on colliding crust? Nature cracked, I take facts, and Occam's razor makes a track. And cause of this, New Zealand has its own Patriot Act. A tide so slick in action, we can't escape the rip. Take a dip in the sinkholes and liquefaction and hard nature stripping our loyal infancy. We were stolen by the Royal Infantry, and the foreshore and seabed was sold to the oil industry. With these aspects drawn together in a naturally forming weather, rainbow clouds and planes scattering matter all in the ether. We Kiwis hardly peep and tend to run from trouble, but that, it could have been me condemned under the rubble. Three stooges enter stage right and charm the meek. See through intentions they strike and command the weak. Policies take flight in daylight, alarms repeat. Arrest Parker, Key and Brownlee and demand they speak. Their band-aid is band-paid, a blank page of plan trade that fits well into the notion that this quake was man-made. On reflection, the second line of the song is wrongly worded. Correction, the people that had gone were murdered.